Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Sri Lanka's grassroots activist sounds alarm on widening gender gap in country's politics. And Nepal's parliamentary committee invites former Home Minister Ramasamy to Northeastern state. In a press conference on Tuesday, Shah said government was prepared with a roadmap outlining a range of efforts for the coming days. However, he added a resolution will not be achieved if both ethnic groups, Kuki and Meitei, don't come to an understanding. He added the main cause of the problem in Manipur is the India-Myanmar border and said that the central government has started fencing this border and has completed 30 kilometers so far, with the CRPF deployed at key points to prevent infiltration.
हाल ही के दिन में दो घटनाएं तीन दिन तक हिंसक घटनाएं हुई. इसको छोड़कर विगत तीन महीनों में कोई बड़ी घटनाएं नहीं हुई थी. अब मणिपुर में अभी भी तीन दिन से शांति है. मुझे आशा है कि हम इस पर बहुत अच्छे से कंट्रोल ले पाएंगे. स्थानीय दोनों जातियों से हमारा संवाद भी है, क्योंकि नस्लीय हिंसा है. जब तक संवाद होकर दोनों के बीच में समाधान नहीं होता, कोई परिणाम नहीं निकल सकता. हम कुकी ग्रुप्स के भी चर्चा कर रहे हैं और मतई ग्रुप से भी चर्चा कर रहे हैं, और आने वाले दिनों में लगभग सभी प्रकार के प्रयास करने के लिए हमने हमारा रोड मैप बनाया है.
At least 225 people have died and some 60,000 have been displaced since fighting broke out last year between the Meitei and Kuki communities over the sharing of economic benefits and quotas in government jobs and education that are given to the tribal Kukis. Fresh incidents of sporadic violence were reported earlier last week. The local government imposed a curfew in the Imphal Valley and surrounding districts last week, and government and private colleges in the state were also ordered shut for a few days. Internet services were restored on Monday and schools are set to reopen on Tuesday, according to a government order, while a partial curfew is still in effect. India has condemned comments made by Iran Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei on the treatment of Muslims in the South Asian nation, calling his remarks misinformed and unacceptable. We cannot consider ourselves to be Muslims if we are oblivious to the suffering that a Muslim is enduring in Myanmar, Gaza, India, or any other place, Khamenei said in a post on X on Monday. Reacting to these remarks, New Delhi said it strongly deplores the comments. In a strongly worded statement, India's Foreign Ministry spokesperson Randhir Jaiswal said, countries commenting on minorities are advised to look at their own record before making any observations about others. India and Iran have typically shared a strong relationship. Recently, the two countries also signed a 10-year contract in May to develop and operate the Iranian port of Chabar. However, the Iranian Supreme Leader has been critical of India in the past over issues involving Muslims in the Muslim-majority region of Kashmir. Days after New Delhi's Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal announced that he won't resume the post until he wins the confidence of people, Aam Aadmi Party on Tuesday elected Atishi as their leader. The announcement by the 54-year-old leader came 2 days after Kejriwal was released from the Tihar jail after being granted bail by the Supreme Court in a corruption case related to the alleged Delhi excise policy scam. Atishi, who currently holds the portfolio of education, finance, law, tourism and several other departments, will tender her resignation later in the day and will be the third woman to hold the post of the Delhi Chief Minister. Kejriwal made the proposal during a legislature party meeting at his residence and the MLA supported him. Kejriwal has also called for advancing polls in the Indian national capital to November this year. The polls are scheduled for February.
मैं सबसे पहले दिल्ली के लोकप्रिय मुख्यमंत्री, आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता मेरे गुरु अरविंद केजरीवाल जी का धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ, जिन्होंने मुझे इतनी बड़ी जिम्मेदारी दी और इस जिम्मेदारी के लिए मुझ पर भरोसा किया। ये सिर्फ आम आदमी पार्टी में हो सकता है, अरविंद केजरीवाल जी के नेतृत्व में हो सकता है कि एक फर्स्ट टाइम पॉलिटिशियन एक राज्य की मुख्यमंत्री बने। मैं एक सामान्य परिवार से आती हूँ, शायद किसी और पार्टी में होती तो चुनाव की टिकट भी नहीं मिलती।
मूविंग ऑन, द बलोच नेशनल मूवमेंट ऑन मंडे होस्टेड एन इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस इन जेनीवा एमिंग टू ड्रॉ ग्लोबल अटेंशन टू द ह्यूमन राइट्स क्राइसिस इन बलोचिस्तान अंडर पाकिस्तानी रूल। अ रिपोर्ट।
The Baloch National Movement on Monday hosted its fifth Balochistan International Conference on the sidelines of the 57th UNHRC session in Geneva, aiming to draw global attention to the human rights violations in Balochistan and the Baloch struggle for rights. Speakers from various fields emphasized the urgent need to address the violent repression faced by the Baloch people under Pakistani rule. They condemned the abductions and enforced disappearances of Baloch activists by the Pakistani military and also highlighted the ongoing protests led by Baloch women in the region.
Speakers, they shared their point of view and they told what atrocities Pakistan is doing. Researchers presented their papers they have done and they highlighted what kind of issues especially the Baloch women are facing.
So, उधर जो है एक जेनोसाइड हो रहा है, ये नहीं कि जेनोसाइड सिर्फ जो है लोगों को मार कर हो रहा है, उधर हर चीज़ का जेनोसाइड, एजुकेशन जेनोसाइड हो रहा है, कल्चरली जो है आपको ख़त्म किया जा रहा है, आपको जो है जो ग्वादर को जो बेसिंग कर रहा है, जिधर के लोग हैं उधर उसी के नाम पर पाकिस्तान जो है एग्रीमेंट कर रहा है इंटरनेशनली, उसी के सिटी के लोगों में जो लोकल लोग हैं उनको जो है पैसे करके बलूचिस्तान से कट कर।
बलोच पीपल हैव लॉन्ग बीन टारगेट्स ऑफ सो कॉल्ड मिलिट्री ऑपरेशंस, एथनिक स्टीरियोटाइपिंग एंड एबडक्शंस बाय द पाकिस्तानी स्टेट while it continues to exploit their natural resources. The situation is not highlighted by the local media, forcing them to seek intervention through global platforms.
The United Nations has announced that the Taliban has suspended all polio vaccination campaigns in Afghanistan. Multiple news reports have suggested the UN agencies were notified about the suspension just days before the scheduled September immunization campaign, though no official reason was provided. Afghanistan and Pakistan remain the only two countries in the world where polio has not been eradicated. In the past, anti-polio campaigns have been regularly marred by violence. Militants target vaccination teams and police assigned to protect them, falsely claiming that the campaigns were a Western conspiracy to sterilize children. In her close-knit, middle-class community nestled in the heart of Sri Lanka's capital, grassroots activist Samudra Jayalath leads a team of volunteers to distribute campaign leaflets for the upcoming presidential election. But the 61-year-old local political leader, who is also a beloved member of the community, is not running for the top job. Instead, she is tapping on her clout to campaign for her presidential candidate of choice, opposition leader Sajith Premadasa. As Sri Lanka grappled with its most severe financial crisis, 17.1 million citizens are set to cast their ballots on September 21 in a crucial presidential election, seeking a new leader to steer the nation towards political stability and economic revival. Jayalath had once hoped her political career would take off after she won a municipal election in 2012. But she has not held any political post at national level despite working for multiple parties for nearly four decades. In a striking omission, the field of 38 candidates lacks a single female representative, highlighting a concerning gender gap in the country's political landscape.
Then parliament e gattama garu mantri varu gattama eyata deshapana pasuvi mak tiyena namuth ehema nathuwa den api wage me bim mattamen ena kaanthawanta etanata yanna hari amaruwe etanata yanna godak kapili kedili tiyena ekat ithin bohoma amaruwen katta kaagena thamai me nagara sabhawa kiyana ekata aave.
Since Sri Lanka introduced the universal franchise in 1931, the number of women in parliament has never crossed the threshold of 7%. Today, they are just 5.3% of its 225 members and have historically held only a fraction of cabinet positions. Women's representation in grassroots governance in Sri Lanka has never crossed 23% despite the spur of a 2016 quota.
Even the electoral system, if you look at the manner in which you have to spend money, preferential voting system, the struggles to get your nomination, all that decision making is in the hands of men. Money is in the hands of men. Access to resources are controlled by male business elite.
The Parliamentary Special Probe Committee formed to investigate the cooperative scam involving former Home Minister Rabi Lami Chane has found him guilty of embezzlement of millions of rupees as a part of the cooperative scam. In the report tabled in the Parliament by the 7-member committee, it was concluded that the millions of rupees injected into Gorkha media came from cooperatives that were traded on the basis of forged documents. The report has stated that the embezzlement of amounts was completed with the active involvement of G.B. Rai, Kumar Ramtel, Rabi Lami Chane and Chabilal Joshi. Former Home Minister Lami Chane had worked in Gorkha Media, the parent company of now-defunct Galaxy 4K Television, as managing director at the time when cooperative savings were invested violating cooperative legislation. Following the tabling and endorsement of the report, House Speaker Devraj Khimre has directed the government to implement the report of the Parliamentary Special Inquiry Committee formed to investigate misappropriation of savings of cooperatives. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.